watching a webisode of Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking on YouTube. Today we're here in Daddy-O's Patio, a venue where we've had a lot of good cookouts and barbecues over the years. If the audio sounds a little odd, it's because we're doing it in a patio greenhouse area. Stay tuned and see what we're cooking up today.
Today's recipe is going to be a jambalaya. I got this recipe from my mom, and it's from a fish restaurant in Mobile Bay, Alabama that was on the wharf. It's pretty good. She could adapt it because we have a lot of oysters and shrimp here on the North Coast. If you don't have fresh oysters, you can always use the ones that come in a jar. Same thing, if you don't have the fresh shrimp, you can always buy the frozen. So if you'd like to see the full recipe for the jambalaya, click on the description of Show More below the video and you'll find it written out there. In addition to the seafood, the shrimp and the oysters, I've also had some green onion, white onion, a green bell pepper, chopped celery, some minced garlic, some butter, a can of tomatoes, some chicken broth, salt, cayenne pepper, and some rice. To prep the raw shrimp, they have that black vein down the back that you pull out. They still have a rather transparent shell around them that when you pull off the tail and remove it, you can take that off in the legs so that when it's ready, it's all cleaned like that. Once you've shucked your oysters, if you're using fresh ones, you'll want to clean them out and rinse them off. If you're using canned or jar ones, you should also do the same to rinse off any particulate matter that might have got in there or shells. You can substitute 1 cup of cubed cooked ham if you don't want to put in the oysters or if they aren't available for you. Today I'm going to use a 12-inch Camp Chef and I'm going to put it inside a Weber barbecue. I want to put the heat underneath at the very bottom. I do have the insert in there. I want to be cooking it so I can saute the onions, the garlic, the celery, and then I want to be able to have it on a low heat for the rest of the ingredients. So I would say a chimney of coals would hold me through for the whole cooking time. Here's the setup inside the Weber. I have the coals on the very bottom, the butter's melting. I'm going to add in the onions, celery, bell pepper, and garlic. I'm going to saute them until they are tender but not browned. Now that the veggies are tender, I'm going to add in both the shrimp and the oysters. I'll cook them for about 5 minutes. If you do not have the oysters and you would rather substitute in ham, add the ham when you put in the rice portion of the recipe. After 5 minutes of cooking that seafood, I went ahead and added in the chicken broth. I chose to use whole tomatoes today, and rice. Make sure that your rice is raw, not the pre-cooked or instant rice. Before I cover it over, I'm going to give it a stir. I added some of the cayenne pepper, a little bit of black pepper, and you can choose whether you want to add salt at this point or wait and season to taste when you get it done. I'm going to cover it up, and I'll be cooking it for about 20 to 25 minutes. After cooking 20 minutes on the low heat, I'm going to check now to see if the rice is tender. It may need to go about another 5 more minutes. If you find at this point that yours is too dry, you can always add in a little bit of tomato juice, and you might decide that you want to take your spoon and cut the tomatoes down a little bit just by pressing on them. Time to activate the smell-o-vision. It's done. It's looking real pretty. We'll plate it up and give it a try. Here we have it, jambalaya. You can season to taste, but at this point it's fine for me. Bon appetit.
Well, that's it for today's webisode. Hope you have a chance to cook up some of your own jambalaya. Remember, it's all about eating good in the great outdoors. Until the next time, happy trails to you.